Hey everyone, welcome y'all. In the today's video, I'm going to show you the elements in the sorted list is basically sorted or not. So here I have a two different multi-selected dropdowns and I can select multiple values in it. And here this is a sorted list and all the elements are in the sorted order by default. So I want to verify whether these elements are in sorted order or not. Okay, so we can verify both. So if I look at the colors, this box is not sorted actually. So this is a sorted list. We will verify both, which one is sorted, which one is not sorted. So for that, I'm opening my Eclipse and go to my project. And inside this, I'm creating a new class. I'll name it as a sorted dropdown list. So in this, I'm taking this main method also. So first of all, we need to create a WebDriver instance. So for that, I say WebDriver driver equal to new Chrome driver I'm trying to use. Now import this WebDriver and Chrome driver. And then I'm trying to launch my application. I say driver.get. You can say driver.get. And here I'm trying to use this application URL. And then I'll try to maximize the page also. I can say driver.manage. window.maximize. So this command will maximize the window, right? So first thing, what is the logic behind that? So first of all, let us take a sorted list. So this is the one, and then we will also verify the unsorted list. So how we can verify the drop-down list is sorted or not? So for that, we need to use something called a collection. So first of all, we need to capture those elements in the two different array lists. So currently these are the elements we have. So we need to capture into two different array lists. So this is, let's say we can call a virginal array list. And we will also capture the same elements in another array list. This is, we can call as a temporary array list. So once you capture all the options in both the two array lists, so we will keep virginal aside and then we will sort this temporary array. We will sort these elements. Okay, for example, let's say currently my elements are arranged in different order. Let's say 2, 4, 1, 3, 5, something like this. 2, 4, 1, 3, 5. So we don't sort the virginal array. Let it be same thing. And we will sort the temporary array. So once it is sorted, the elements will be in sorted order. And after getting the sorted order of elements, we will compare with the virginal array. Virginal array elements, sorted elements. So if exactly that we find the same order of elements, then that sorted list is sorted. So those elements are in sorted. So this is simple logic which we need to apply. So for that, what I'm going to do is, first of all, let us capture the options from this sorted list into two different array lists. So for that, I'm creating two different array lists. But before that, let us capture these elements and then we will store them in a two different array list. So how we can handle this drop down? So if I inspect this element, basically it is a select box. So we can use select class from Selenium WebDriver to capture all these options. Now, if I go back and see selector hub and it is giving the XPath of that element. Now I'm capturing this drop down element. I can say driver.find element. By dot XPath. So this is the element just I'm going to pass in the select class object. I can say select dropdown equal to new select. Now inside the select class, I'm just passing this dropdown element. Now let us import this select class. So now we need to find out and capture all the options from the dropdown. So how we can capture this? So after capturing the options from the dropdown, we have to store in two different array list. Okay. So let me create two different array list variables. I can create array list and I call it as a virginal list. The first one is virginal list equal to new array list. So new array list. And similarly, I'm also taking one more array list, which is a temporary list. I can call it as a temp list. Import this array list class. Right, so now we need to capture the options from the dropdown and store them in both the array list. So for that, I'm using one for each loop. So I'm taking this dropdown. So from the dropdown, how to capture all the options using get options method. So this will return all the options. And if you need, you can write another statement if you want. You can say drop down dot get options. This will return all the options in the form of web element. I'm storing them in a variable called options. And then I can find these are the options. Basically, this is written list of web element. Right. So now we need to import this list collection as well as this web element. Right now we can capture options from this one by one into this option. That option I want to store in a array list. So I'm capturing each and every individual option one by one. So this is again web element. Right. So now this particular option, which is web element, basically store in both the two both array list. So how we can add these options to the array list? You can take original list dot add, and he can say option. Same thing we can do for temp list also. Copy the same thing, and here this is temp list dot add option. Same option we have added to the temp list. So once this loop is completed, all the options will be captured into both the array list, original list and temporary list. So now let us print both the array list before sorting. So I'm just trying to print. So I can just print like this, system.out.println. So printing, or you can say before sorting. I'm just printing both the array list before sorting. So I'm just writing simply, instead of writing a loop statement, I'm just directly printing the array list. And similarly, I'll also print, this is the original list, and I'm also printing the temporary list. So I'll also give some description here. This is original list before sorting. And this is temporary list. I can say temp list also before sorting. So before sorting, both will be the same. So let us execute and see. Okay, now I have launched my page and captured the data. Let me close it. So now if I look at here, this is the original list of elements. So basically it is not printing. It's basically capturing the objects. So we need to just print the get text, right? So not options. We need to store text of the option. So I can say dot get text. And here also we say dot get text, because we can store all the options in the array list, but we are capturing the get text because we can compare the text. So let me execute now once again. Right. So now we can just go and back and see. You will see the elements in the original array list, and these are the elements in the temporary list. So both are exactly the same for now. So now we will keep this original list aside. We don't sort it. First, we will sort the temporary list. So after sorting, again, those elements are exactly same like original list. Then the list box is sorted. Right. So now how we can sort this array list? So to sort this array list, I'm using a built-in method called collections dot sort. So whenever you want to sort a collection, use this collections dot sort method. Simply you can pass whichever list you want to sort. So I'm just want to sort the temporary list that I'm passing. So this will be sorted the list, temp list. So once it is sorted temp list, again I'm printing the data from both original and temporary list after sorting. We can say this is before sorting. Now I'm just printing the data from both the array list after sorting the temporary list. Now execute one more time. Okay, now I can just go back and see. Yes, now you can see this is the before sorting the data from both the list, and after sorting you can see this is the original list actually, and this is a temporary list. This is the temporary list and this is the original list. So basically, this is a sorted array. So that's the reason you're getting the same data, same order in versional list and a temporary list also. If the data order and the data values, if both are exactly the same, then that is a sorted list. So now we need to compare these two array list. After sorting, we need to compare it. So how to compare two array list using if condition? I'm going to compare this. Simply, I can say if. So the versional list, we haven't touched the versional list. So that is equals is a method through which we can compare the both array list equals. Now after sorting, we need to compare with the temporary list. So if both are exactly equal, then we can confirm the list box is sorted. You can simply say list box is sorted. And else, if both are not equal, you can simply say list box is not sorted. Right. So after that, I'm closing my browser driver. I can say driver.quit. That's it. So this is how we can simply implement the logic. So let me run it. So currently I'm using, this is a sorted dropdown. I'm using sorted list, or you can say multi-sorted dropdown. Let's execute now. Now launching my page, it is done. So now we can see my list box is successfully sorted. You can see the elements before sorting and after sorting, the order and the elements are exactly the same. So my list box is already sorted. Elements are in the sorted. Now let me take unsorted list box. So what I'm doing is, this is my sorted dropdown. So instead of that, I'm going to pass unsorted list. So let me comment this. Now I'm just passing unsorted list. So this time I'm taking another dropdown from the same page. If I go back and see, I have another dropdown here, colors. So let's inspect this element. And this is also a select box. Go back to selector hub and see. So I'm just passing this into select class object. So driver.find element by.xpath. This is my xpath. Okay. So now previously when I pass this element, the elements are in the sorted order. Now I'm passing a different dropdown. So now this time we will see whether it is sorted or not. Now execute one more time. Perfect. Now you can see before sorting, these are the elements. Both the original list and template is exactly the same. But after sorting, if I look at here, the original list is having these elements in the same order. But the temporary list, whatever we have sorted, the elements order is got changed. So now there is a mismatch between these two. So the list box is not sorted. So this is how we can simply write a logic to check whether the list box elements are sorted order or not. Okay. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching.